The best way I can describe this game is like riding Kings of Ka at Six Flags. 90% of the experience is waiting for something interesting to happen, then the next 10% is the ride itself. Intense, but ends anticlimactically. The game seemed so boring at first. Someone dunking on Luke? Eh, I've seen this one before. Towards the end, however, Luke turns the momentum all the way up. Only problem is that he also turned up Dylan's momentum. Luke ends up losing as Dylan fully wraps up the number one seed. Dylan has been on fire, winning 6 games straight. Let's hope he makes some noise this postseason. As for Luke, your season's practically over. You were just one Ben and AJ win away from elimination. You need blood magic to make it now. Both of these guys are still in the running, but both need to win out to make it. If successful, this game will decide seeding. If unsuccessful, this game will practically send someone home. Speaking of home, AJ never left home. Playing this conservatively is how to not win games. Sure, on paper this game looks close, but the first half of the game, AJ wasn't there, and Ben was reaping the benefits. But then, AJ responds, "It's about fucking time you woke up, AJ." Unfortunately for AJ, he should have woken up earlier, because playing without an offense doesn't fucking work. Not only did Ben save this game itself may have just saved his entire season. He just needs a win against Jake or Sully, and he's in the playoffs. As for AJ, it's still possible for you to drunkenly stumble into the playoffs, but unless things change, he's a one and done for sure. A battle between two explosive offenses that don't know when to stop playing offense. They both had misses because of their firepower. However, which player here will take the dub? The one who ironically plays more conservatively? In this case, it is Eric. This is a game that could have gone either way, but Eric was the chosen winner this time around. If only Sully could control that offense. Speaking of Sully, he's officially circling the drain. He needs a bunch of miracles to even make the third seed at this point. We'll see if this tank's successful or not. Back to the delayed games once again. Zach once again showing that he doesn't give a fuck. Why would we expect anything to change at this point? Dropping out of the league would be the best option at this point. You know, as the saying goes, just shut up and dribble. Or in this case, sink balls. Unlike all the other Zach games, this game just did not happen because scheduling just did not work out this week. This game is expected to be played either week 8 or 9, and this game will most likely decide the fate of the third seed since I don't expect Zach to even qualify by the end of the season. I'm not even going to waste my time about talking about this delay. Just expect Eric to be handed a free win next week. Well, that's it for this episode. Yeah, I am still doing this series. I'm going to do it all the way to the end of season 3, but I'm not doing season 4. Alright, if you guys even care, leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.